believe it is the Holy Spirit that will empower our witness and empower the church. And without the Holy Spirit, we will do nothing. It is through His power and through Him as our benefactor that we are able to see signs and wonders that follow those who believe. When I left China, I was a boy, and Pastor Monk was then 41 years of age, the same age as my dad at the time. I did not see him again until 1988. He was 80 years of age when I finally saw him again. I spent 16 years in prison, 9 years on probation, finally able to get repossession of the church property, opened it with 30 people, when he was 75 years of age. 75 years of age. All kinds of restrictions against propagating the gospel. Cannot baptize anyone under the age of 18. Cannot indoctrinate in the church anyone under the age of 18. Everyone baptized must, their name and address must be turned over to the government for registration as a Christian. I said to him, Pastor Monk, how many believers do you have now? He said, we have 1,500 adult baptized believers. I looked at him shocked, and I said to him, how did this happen? He looked at me like I'd asked one of those American questions. What conference did you go to? Books did you read? All that's well and good, and it said it. I'll never forget his answer. He said to me, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and we pray a lot. Every morning at 5:30 in the morning, a number of us saints gather together and we pray, oh, Holy Spirit, move today in Xining. Can you imagine the difference it would make if in all of our assemblies we would have moments when we would say, oh, Holy Spirit, today, move in this church, yes. Move in this town, yes. Move yes. In this community. Yes. We are great learners in America. We study church growth. We attend conferences. We read books. We scour the internet for resources, sometimes on Saturday night with somebody else's sermon, which God cannot bless you if you do that. In our fellowship, we have great methods, great tools for evangelism, great tools for discipleship, church growth, relational healing, a host of other things, but it is still not by might nor by power, but by so when we invite the Holy Spirit, He gives us His presence. And that truth is beautifully put in words in a hymn written by Lucy Ryder Meyer and Jackie Hoyt.